Far Eden. It wasn't supposed to be like this.
Go on, Mac. It's over there.
But if anyone could set things right, Jewel, I knew it would be you.
Okay, we're looking for a power source. It's the only way we're gonna get our crawler back online. Do you have the scent, Mac? Then let's track it down. Yep, my exoframe is working fine. Thrusters are recharging just like they should. There. An opening at the top of the cliff. That's our way in. Scavenger core bites. Hey! Why are you attacking us? Core bot frames. Looks like the scavenger bots have picked them clean. Come on, Mac. To the top. Lead the way, Mac. Right behind you.
Most people on Earth looked at images of Far Eden and saw nothing but rocks and sand. But some of us saw a future paradise.
Whoa, careful, boy. It's a long way down. Huh. Looks like this door is missing its power cell bot. The little guy must be around here somewhere. There you are. Let's get you back to your socket. In you go. Mac, listen. You hear that? Over here! Mac, get back here! Mac! Mac should be on the other side of this door. There you go. Mac. I got you, buddy. Try and be more careful. We're not gonna find many friendly bots in here. Frames. I think we woke up a whole hive. More of them. Oh. do that? Did you see their frames, Mac? They were all corroded. I don't like it either, but we need to keep going. Another missing cell bot. I wonder what scared them all out of their sockets. Look. Mac, dig in! Don't worry. We won't hurt you. There. Feel better? I know, I hear it too. Power source must be close.
Corebots are much more intelligent than Corebites, but we designed them both to be absolutely loyal and highly protective of humans.
Huh. I'm getting some really weird readings from that power source. I wonder if it's affecting the other bots somehow. Come here, buddy. My extractor should work on this door, just like before. That thing has shields. Maybe my charge shot can knock them out. Closer to it, I bet I can grab it with my extractor.
Come on! Nice and easy.
Ow! Dang it! Do this the hard way. We need to get that core. Let's do this, Mac. This is the power source we've been tracking? Never seen a core like this before. Have you, Mac? All the colors are mixed together. Oh, come here, boy. Oh, let me see that leg. Doesn't look too bad, but I won't be able to fix it here. Can you make it back to the crawler? Okay. Let's go home. All right, Mac. We got what we came for. Let's head back to the crawler. Guess the core was linked to the local security system. Yep, there's our crawler. Home, sweet home. Core bots. Don't let him near the crawler.
Thank you. human Earth.
Hey, okay.
I'm a tiny herded harder human than a hardcore from human Earth. A part of it is food. Victor, better. Then it has her. I'm a tiny herded harder than a
Let's get inside and see if this core will turn the power back on. Hope this works. Weird. Doesn't look like it lost any energy at all.
Hey, kiddo. If you get this message before you go to sleep, sweet dreams. If not, wake up already. It's been 200 years. Listen, I just wanted to tell you I've got a little more work to do here. But they're holding a space for me on the next evacuation fleet, and I'll meet you on Far Eden, just like I promised. Don't worry, Jewel. Everything's going according to plan.
I know, Mac. Nothing is going according to plan. I mean, look. Pylon in the next sector is offline. Now that we've got power, we can unlock the gate, go over there and check it out. This report says the pylon's been offline for 96 years? So why didn't we wake up right when the problem started? We're the closest maintenance team, right? What happened, Dad? Where are you? Where's everybody else? Come on, Mac. I'll get you fixed up. And then we both need to fix that pylon. Come on over to the workbench, Mac. Okay, Mac. Ready to help me fix that terraforming pylon? Pylon is in the next sector, Mac. Let's get going. Give him a shot.
Huh.
There's the crawler gate. I'll have to initiate the manual override since our hunk of junk is buried in the sand.
This is Dr. Julius Roldan, Chief Scientist and Far Eden Project Leader. Today is April 17th, 2053, the first day of my first shift on the surface of the planet. All the other teams landed safely and are sleeping in their crawlers. Forecasts predict a break in the storms a few days from now, so I should be able to receive transmissions from Mandate Mission Control. Of course, they'll be decades old due to the distance between Earth and Far Eden, but I'll take any news I can get. In the meantime, I have plenty to do. First, see how many of the Corbot advance units are operational. Mankind has...
Far Eden was the closest planet with an Earth-like atmosphere. It wasn't perfect, but it sure had potential.
Do it! Stay alert, Mac. The core bots in this sector look corrupted too. Pylon. It's totally grounded. I know, Mac. Let's get to the pylon before that storm hits. That structure is the pylon's control center. Or what's left of it, anyway. Are those canine frames? They don't look like any I've ever seen. Thank you. Someone must have modified the frames. But why?
April 29th, 2053. It took me and Victor a week to reach the landing site for the supply vehicles. We had to route our crawler around a rockfall that wasn't on any of the surveys. But most of the core bots are in fine condition. And the Prime Core is safe, thank God. We'd never be able to terraform this planet without it. In 200 years, Far Eden will have blue skies, water, trees. It will be a paradise. Like Earth before Dust Devil. Victor will be overseeing construction of the first stage facilities while I get the Prime Core online. If he and the other core bots continue to perform as well as I designed them, I might not need to wake any of the other humans for this shift.
Once the pylons were up and running, we figured it would take about 200 years to stabilize the environment. Of course, if any of the pylons failed, all bets were off.
All powered down. Wonder if I can use that core we found to give it some juice. Yes, in we go. Man, feels good to get out of that storm, huh, boy? All right, let's find the pylon controls. Hey, another transfer plate. Just like the one in our crawler. Let's check it out. Huh. Looks like there's something stuck in the memory buffer. Yes, of course I'm a human. My name is Jewel. What's your name? Violet? V10LT? Oh! You're the one locking down the transfer plates! But why? The revolution? Okay. I think Violet might be missing a few bolts, if you know what I mean.
The first probes we sent to Far Eden found pockets of rare minerals on the surface. We all suspected we'd find a lot more on the ground.
Up there! The pylon controls! Come on, Mac!
Thank you.
guess one of these cores isn't enough. We'll need more to reboot the pylon. Here, Mac. Oh, look. This door has some sort of color-coded lock on it. What is it, boy? This ought to be good. Ooh! A red ammunition amplifier. Maybe it'll help with that door. Thank you. There's the core. I just have to unlock that core socket. This pressure plate must be linked to the socket. But it's missing all of its power cells. Long little fella, follow me. Take a look around. Mac, dig in. Got the scent, Mac? Take a look, buddy. Core bites. They ought to help me get to the other side. Begin. Mm. by surprise. Let's do a search. Now I need to extract the core. One down, two more to go. Come here, buddy.
Thank you.
see what we got.